Good evening, everybody. Welcome to your Daily Bread passage for Saturday, September 3rd, 2022, in episode 832, part 2. And in this one, we're going to be learning how to be rooted in love from Zachel Dixon, derived from Ruth 2, 5-13. So if you're excited about this one, smash the like button. Birthdays, anniversaries, and prayer requests in the comment section below. And how are you rooted in love? And also let me know how your Saturday has went. If you ain't finished with it, come back later time and let me know. And let me know when you come back at a later time, what time of the day you're commenting. So I go, okay. But subscribe if you're new, turn on notifications, share the video and channel with your family and friend. Help me reach 25 to 30 subscribers by the first day of fall. And if you do that for me, I will greatly appreciate each and every one that helps me get there. So let's get on the ball, get that number up, get that number there. So, but without further ado, let's be rooted in love. Zachel Dixon, she writes, I arrived at the cancer care center where I'd be serving as my mom's life in caregiver, feeling alone and afraid. I left my family and support system more than 750 miles behind me. But before I could even touch my luggage, Frank, a man with a huge grin, offered to help. By the time we reached the sixth floor, I had made plans to meet his wife, Lori, who cared for him during his treatments. The couple soon became like family, as we leaned on God and each other. We laughed, vented, cried, and prayed together. Though we all felt displaced, our connection to God and each other kept us rooted in love as we supported one another. So when Ruth committed to caring for her mother-in-law, Naomi, she left the security of familiarity behind. Ruth entered a field and began to glean behind the harvesters. Ruth 2, verse 3. The overseer told the landowner, Boaz, that Ruth came into the field and remained working except for a short rest in the shelter. Verse 7. Ruth found a safe place with people willing to care for her as she cared for Naomi. Verses 8 and 9. And God provided for Ruth and Naomi through Boaz's generosity. Verses 14 through 16. And we later find out Boaz falls in love with Ruth, and then they get married, or Naomi. I don't remember which one he falls for. But life circumstances can provide roads to unexpected places far beyond our comfort zones. And as we remain connected to God and each other, He'll keep us rooted in love as we support one another. So how has God comforted you when you felt alone? Have you ever felt alone? And how has God made you feel? Or comforted you during that time of loneliness? How has He used other people to support you through a community rooted in His love? Name a time that happened. But ponder those questions by saying this phrase, which should be on the bottom of the screen, so make sure your subtitles are on so you can see it. But say, Loving Father, thank you for promising to be with me and providing all I need. Amen? So for further study today, read this article, What is Real Love? At discoveryseries.org/BigQ0714. That link should be on the screen, and the link will be in the description box as well. But it'll also be on the screen so you can actually see what I'm reading. I'm reading the website so you could see it. And it'll be that way in the description box as well. So But your Bible reading for this one today is Psalm 140 through 142. Inching closer to that Psalm 150. And we'll be done with Psalms again. And then also 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verses 1 through 20. So coming up tomorrow in your first beautiful, glorious Lord's Day Sunday, Daily Bread passage, in episode 832. Today was 8. Friday was 831 or 830. Saturday 831. And then Sunday's 832, part 2. So sorry for the mix-up with the numbers. The numbers will be in the title, so if I messed up, I'm sorry. But today's was 831, part 2. And tomorrow's videos will be 832, part 1 and 2. But part 2, we're going to learn how to be rediscovered. From Lisa M. Samra, S-A-M-R-A, derived from 2 Chronicles 34, 29 through 31. So stay tuned for that. I'll get to that later tonight, but you'll see that one tomorrow. And also coming up tomorrow is your first weekend series, Turning Point Weekend Series video for September 3rd and 4th. And it's going to be the title of the series is Big Moments. And number one, we're going to be talking about the big moment of salvation. 2 Thessalonians 2:13 is the beginning passage. Titus 2:11 through 15 is the recommended reading. Turning point is from Billy Graham. And your Bible reading for the weekend is Ezekiel 31 through 35. So read 31, 32, and half of 33 today, and then tomorrow I'll read the rest of 33, 34, and 35. So just split it up for the weekend. But stay tuned for those. I'll get those later tonight, but you'll see those tomorrow. So with that said, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God, and He'll keep you safe and all you say and do in 2022 and beyond. And until tomorrow, peace out, everybody. God bless everyone. Hope you have a great rest of your Jubilant Saturday afternoon and the rest of your evening. And come back tomorrow for another glorious Lord's Day Sunday, the first one of the month, and see what God has in store for us tomorrow. So with that said, God bless everyone, and I'll see you tomorrow. Ha ha. Goodbye.